Straight first to our headlines today, exclusive report. Of all the challenges confronting him, the one closest to Amit Shah's heart is BJP's Mission Kashmir. The new BJP president is personally supervising an ambitious, never-before-attempted master plan to install a BJP chief minister in Jammu and Kashmir. So will the most contentious state, which is also a Muslim-majority state, get a Hindu chief minister? Headlines today has the inside story of the new BJP president's ambitious plan.
He's easily the busiest man on a bustling political landscape, hero of the 2014 campaign. But there's no time for rest. The new president of the BJP has his hands fuller than ever before. But there's one mission that stands above all, and it's something that's never seriously been tried before. BJP's Mission Kashmir. The new BJP president is personally supervising an ambitious, never-before-attempted master plan to install a Hindu chief minister in Jammu and Kashmir. BJP leaders and RSS cadre are already working overtime to achieve what no one has so far thought possible, having a Hindu elected as chief minister of India's most contentious state. Headlines today has exclusive access to details of Amit Shah's four-pronged strategy. 1. Consolidate gains made during the Lok Sabha elections in the state. 2. Embark on a huge campaign to enroll Kashmiri Pandits across the country. 3. Break away popular leaders from other parties. 4. Forge tactical understandings with regional players. If the BJP is able to replicate its Lok Sabha performance in the assembly elections, the party will end up with a substantial 33 seats in the 88-seat assembly, and most likely emerge as the single largest party in the case of a fractured mandate. But the BJP is not relying only on Jammu and Ladakh. Shah aspires to make dents in the Kashmir Valley as well. BJP leaders and RSS workers have embarked on a massive enrollment campaign to get Kashmiri Pandits to vote no matter where they are settled in the country. Door-to-door enrollment is currently being carried out in Jammu, Delhi, Noida, Ghaziabad and pockets of Punjab that have heavy concentration of the Pandit community. The BJP leadership is in touch with several prominent leaders who have a strong support base and are unhappy in their present parties. In the past few weeks, many senior state-level leaders have already been inducted into the BJP. To boost its post-poll position, the BJP is looking at forging different kinds of tactical understanding with some of the smaller regional players in the state. Seat-sharing talks are on with the Panthers party of Dr. Bhim Singh. BJP leaders are also in touch with the Imam Khomeini Memorial Trust, which has pockets of influence in Ladakh.
This is a change in the mindset of the people of Kashmir. So I really feel that 44 plus will be achieved very nicely and very effectively.
For Amit Shah, failure is not an option. The BJP strongman is understood to be putting everything on the line for the party's Mission Kashmir. Given the BJP's track record in the state, any talk of the party emerging as the single largest in the state at this time seems far-fetched. But given the electoral miracle that Amit Shah was able to pull off in Uttar Pradesh, and considering how seriously he's pushing Mission Kashmir, the effort could be more than a pipe dream. Regardless of whether the party succeeds or not, this winter we'll see a lot of political heat being generated in Jammu and Kashmir.
BJP's ambition in Jammu and Kashmir is perhaps, it looks all right, but it looks beyond possibility as long as they don't do a drastic image makeover in Jammu and Kashmir.
I don't think it's possible. It has been in the last elections that BJP has been able to grab more than two seats. That too happened because of the communal agenda of BJP.
Modi's full might is behind the mission, having visited Jammu and Kashmir twice already since he took over as Prime Minister. The message is no longer subliminal. India's only Muslim-dominated state is being eyed by the Bharatiya Janata Party. In New Delhi, this is Rahul Kanwal reporting for Headlines Today.